Today's lecture is heat conduction in an electric heat source. In an electric heat source. When I say electric heat source, the very simplest example which comes into mind is basically an electric wire. An electric wire, okay, which is normally a cylindrical wire in shape, and when the current flows through this wire, with the passage of time, it starts dissipating some heat to the surroundings. So we're gonna derive that expression of heat being dissipated when the current passes through this electric wire. So in this, we'll consider an electric wire with a cross-sectional radius R and electrical conductivity of electrical conductivity as Ke, with the units ohm inverse, centimeter inverse. Through this wire, an electric current with the current density, an electric current with the current density I flows. The units of this current density is ampere per centimeter square. Now, the transmission of this current through this wire, it's an irreversible process. Irreversible process. And some part of this electrical energy gets converted into the heat or some sort of your thermal energy. So, rate of heat production per unit volume is given as SE, which is having the formula that is I square by KE. So that's the rate of amount of heat production or generated per unit volume, that is SE as I square by KE. Now the quantity SE is basically the heat which is being generated because of, or you can say it's because of electric dissipation. Electrical dissipation. That is, this much amount of heat is being, converted into the heat. That is electric dissipation. Now, over here we assume that the temperature rise in the wire. So amount of this heat transfer, there will be a temperature increase in the wire. It's not so large, but it's not quite high. Suddenly the temperature difference between the wire and the surrounding is more than 10 degrees Celsius. The temperature is not so large that the temperature dependency is either on the thermal or electrical conductivity needs to be considered. That is, it's independent of those conditions. So also the surface temperature of the wire is maintained at temperature T naught. We can write it over here that the surface temperature of the wire is T naught. So we'll determine how the temperature within the wire varies with respect to the radial direction. So we're going to find out temperature distribution as a function of the radial direction. And if you can compare it with the, the one which we have done in the momentum flow, that is, the fluid is moving under the pressure effect, and with that pressure effect there is a momentum and the velocity generation occurring within this pipe, and that velocity generation is a function of the radial direction. So it's somewhat similar to this. So the current is flowing through this. So as a result, there is a temperature difference, uniform temperature distribution is occurring within the wire, and that temperature distribution is a function of radial direction. So we're going to find out the similarities. So you're going to see the similarities between both the systems. Moving further, so let's consider a wire. Let's say this is the center of axis of the wire, and let's say that's the wire, the radial direction. So we consider a shell of thickness dr, and we're going to apply the shell balance on this thickness dr, and the length of the wire which is to be considered is l. Now for this, first rate of thermal energy across the cylindrical surface at r, that is through this, let's say this is distance r from the center. So what will be the amount of thermal energy that is flowing across this distance r? That will be the surface area of the shell, 2 pi r l into qr at r. Similarly, the same thing in the outward direction, that is from this outward, so it will be 2 pi r l into qr at r plus delta r. And then is rate of production of thermal energy by electric dissipation, that is because of this term. So how much of energy is being, you know, produced because of this electric dissipation, that will be the, you know, the volume of this shell. So that can be written as area pi r delta r square minus pi r square into l will be the volume into se. So that will result in 2 pi r delta r l into se. So we have in, we have out, and we have the production term. So our main equation, that is rate of thermal energy in minus rate of thermal energy out plus rate of production of thermal energy is equal to rate of accumulation of thermal energy. Now under steady state, the accumulation part will be zero. So under steady state, this part is zero. So what is left is 2 pi L into R QR minus 2 pi L into R QR at R plus delta R. Let's say this is at R, plus the generation term, that is 2 pi R delta R L into SE is equal to zero. So what we do is we divide by 2 pi delta R L and takes the limit delta R approaches zero. So what we are left with is minus d by dr of r qr plus ser equal to zero, and this will lead to d by dr of r qr equal to ser. Now upon integrating, so we have r qr as ser square by 2 plus some constant c. Now from here we can write QR as SER by 2 plus C by R. We have C by R. Now at the center, at the center, that is at R equal to zero, the heat flux is minimum or least. So therefore, QR cannot be infinite if we put this condition over here. So therefore, C has to be zero. So therefore, we are left with this QR as SCR by 2. We are left with this condition. Now, introducing the Fourier law of heat conduction. Of heat conduction, QR is minus K dT by dR. So we have minus K dT by dR as SCR by 2. So which upon integration will lead to T is equal to minus SC R square by 4K plus the constant C. Now the boundary conditions. R square. Now the boundary conditions at R equal to capital R, the temperature is T is equal to T naught. So C2 comes out to be SC R square by 4K plus T naught. So as a result, we have T minus T naught is equal to SE R square by 4K. If you substitute this back over here, into 1 minus R by capital R whole square. So that's the temperature distribution. And if you see, this is somewhat equal to your parabolic distribution. So if you plot between R by capital R, so that will be the plot of your temperature distribution between T minus T naught and R by capital R. So this is the temperature distribution as a function of R. Now, if you find out the maximum temperature will occur at the center, that is at R equal to zero. So the maximum temperature is T max minus T naught is equal to SE R square by 4K. And if you find out the average temperature, so for average temperature, so T average minus T naught will be nothing but the volumetric flow rate or the volumetric distribution of the temperature, TR minus TR into R dr d theta into R dr d theta, where R varies from 0 to 2 pi, sorry, theta from 0 to 2 pi, and R varies from 0 to capital R, 0 to 2 pi and 0 to capital R. And if you upon integrate, if you substitute that expression of T minus TR, T minus T, this TR is basically the radial distribution. So we can also write TR minus T naught. So if you substitute this expression over here and integrate, so you will end up as SCR square by 8. So this is the average temperature distribution. So average temperature distribution is S square by 4. So you can see the average temperature distribution is half of the maximum temperature distribution. So maximum temperature distribution is SE square by 4K, whereas the average temperature distribution is half of it, that is 50% of it. Also, now if you find out the total amount of heat outflow at the surface over the entire length, capital L. So that will be Q is equal to 2 pi r l into q r, and this r will occur at the radius. So what is q r at capital R? So that is 2 pi into capital R l, that is the entire surface area of the pipe or the wire, into q r at r equal to capital R. And what is q r at, this is sc r by 2, so it becomes 2 pi r l into SE capital R by 2. So this becomes pi R square L into SE. And what is SE? SE was the total amount of heat, dissipated per unit volume. And into volume will be the total amount of heat which is outflow or dissipated at the surface. So it is nothing but this thing. So you can say this is nothing but your energy dissipated into the volume, because it was energy dissipated per unit volume into volume will give you the total amount of heat dissipated, and this is nothing but your pi r square l into SE. Now if you compare the results of your this temperature distribution with the wire, and I can clearly see there are a lot of similarities between the heat flown through the wire and your flow through the tube flow. So we can, similarize the things. So let me write, over here, that is tube flow, that is fluid flow through the pipe. And over here, it's basically the heated wire or the current flow through the wire. Current flow through the wire. Now, the first integration, in the tube flow was your momentum flux, tau rx. Whereas in the heat flow, it's the heat flux, q r. The second integration in the tube flow resulted in the velocity expression, whereas in the heat flux, it resulted in the temperature distribution, TR minus T0. Boundary conditions. The first boundary condition was that at the center, the momentum flux is minimum, whereas over here at the center, the heat flux is minimum. Second boundary condition, at the wall, the velocity is zero, and at the wall over here, the temperature was T naught, so T minus T naught is zero. The third is the transport property. Transport property in the fluid flow was your viscosity, whereas in this case it was the thermal conductivity. The source for the flow. Over here, the source for the flow was the pressure drop, that is delta P by L. Whereas in this case, the source was your the energy dissipation, that is SE. Assumptions. In the fluid flow, the assumption was the viscosity was kept as constant, whereas in heat wire, the thermal conductivity or the electrical conductivity was kept as constant. So you can completely see the a good number of analogy between the heated flow, heat wire, and your electrical wire. So first integration resulted in the flux, second resulted in the the velocity distribution or the temperature distribution. Then we have similar boundary conditions, and we have the transport property, the source for the flow of the fluid in the tube, and the flow of the current in the wire, and the assumptions, basically the thermal conductivity or the viscosity is kept constant. Clear? Now let's take one more example. Now, let's, you know, in a similar case, initially what we kept was the surface temperature was kept as constant, that is T naught. Now, let's take a special case. Now, we repeat the same thing, assuming now that the T naught, that is the surface temperature, is not known, but instead at the surface, there is a heat loss to the surroundings. There is a heat loss to the surroundings. And at the surface, the heat flux is given by the Newton law of cooling. So let's repeat the same process. You can write the special case for heated wire. The special case. Now we repeat the same process, but instead at the surface, T naught is not known. Also, the heat flux at the wall is given by Newton's law of cooling. That is, we assume the heat transfer coefficient as H and ambient temperature as T air. The ambient temperature is T air. So now we need to find out the temperature distribution in the wire. I need to find out the temperature distribution of wire. Instead, at the surface, the temperature is not known. Also, at the surface, there is a cooling occurring, and that is because of this Newton law. And in this cooling, the heat transfer coefficient is H, and the ambient temperature is TA. Now, at the surface, the flux. We know the flux, that is QR at R equal to capital R, is SE capital R by 2. Sorry, by 2. Also, at the surface, there is Newton law of cooling occurring. So Q is nothing but H times T minus T air. That is, this is the temperature in the wire, and this is the temperature occurring. So if you generate both the terms, that is at R equal to capital R, if you compare both the terms, so what we have is HT minus T air is equal to SE R square by 2. And from here, T is nothing but SE R by 2H plus T air. That is T. This is the temperature within at the surface. Temperature at the surface. Clear? Or since QR is H of T minus T air at the surface. And what is this? Minus K dT by dR, HT minus T air. So from here, If you look at the temperature distribution, temperature distribution was T is equal to minus SE R square by 4K plus C2. That was the temperature. If you substitute this QR SER by 2 and minus K dT by dR equal to this, you're going to end up as this term, that is temperature is minus SER square by 4K plus C2. Now at the surface, that is at R equal to capital R, what is happening is T is equal to SE R square by 2H plus T air. That is, this is the temperature at the surface. So if you substitute this term over here, we're going to find out the value of C2. So C2 comes out to be SER square by 2H plus SER square by 4K plus T air. So this is the temperature distribution within the wire, and this is the temperature at the wall because of the Newton law of cooling. So if you substitute at R equal to capital R, so and T is equal to this expression, so you have the expression of C2, which comes out to be this thing. So now if you substitute it back over here, so you have T minus T air is equal to SER by 2H. Where is, okay, then it's not square over here. So we have SER by 2H plus SER square by 4K into 1 minus small r by capital R whole square. So this is the temperature distribution if the surface temperature is not known. But as the temperature increases, as the heat increases, the temperature distribution is given some sort of a parabolic along with the radial input. That is, it starts increasing and it reaches to where there is a Newton law of cooling occurring. There is a cooling occurring at the surface also. So you can say the temperature distribution won't be zero. It will be something like something occurring at like this. It will be a parabolic because of this character. And once it reaches at the surface, so there is a heat dissipation and it starts losing air, the heat to the air. So jitna zyada air temperature kam hoga, surrounding temperature kam hoga, utna hi zyada heat loss hogi from the wire towards the atmosphere. So this is the temperature distribution of the the temperature in the electric wire or in the heated wire. Once the surface temperature is not known, but at the surface is a heat loss occurring to the surroundings, and because of that heat loss, this will be the temperature profile. Clear? So this is some sort of a special case where the electric wire is being heated and it's kept openly in the atmosphere. So that's why we have the insulation occurring at the wires. That's why those metal wires are being insulated, so that in order to minimize this heat loss to the surroundings. Clear? Now, any question you need to ask?